We've just seen Martin Lutman put his name in the hat for the fourth round here at the UK Open. One of these two will join him there. Who knows, could end up playing him. We won't know till the draw is done later. But the legendary Australian Simon Whitlock, a man who has won a major title in the PDC, former European champion, of course, a two-time quarter-finalist in the UK Open, 2017 and 2021. Beaten by Daryl Gurney back in 17 and James Wade in the quarterfinals 3 years ago. Last year, he managed to win against Ross Montgomery before losing out to Martin Schindler. The year before, he beat Maik Kuivenhoven before getting knocked out by Peter Snakebite Rice. And these two meet again 2 years on, with Kuivenhoven looking to book his place in the next round when the big boys enter the fray. He's already won against Barry Van Peer, which is no mean feat. Average 99 in the process. Any more of that, and it might well be enough to see off the Wizard, who obviously is enduringly popular and is darts, but he is not the force that he was, and he's certainly not as consistent as he used to be.
Yeah, I think it's fair to say it. His work ethic in trying to prepare for seasons like this has always been exceptional. But he is a senior dart player now, and he's not seen as fallible as he once was. He's now in the 40s in the rankings.
40.
And he's not making the likes of match players and Grand Prix and European Championships as often as he once did. But it does beg the question of what next evolution is coming, because every time he seems to have a dip, and this is the biggest dip so far, how's he going to dig his way out? Because previously he just finds a way.
Yeah, he's had dips before, hasn't he? He had basically a year and a half where he could barely win a game on the telly, but his Pro Tour form was still good. Then when his Pro Tour form wasn't good in the last few years, he had some big TV runs that propped things up, and there was always something coming. But the minute we're in a phase where it feels like one of the great careers in this sport is fading, and yeah, he still puts in these performances which show you he's got more to give. But as we know, doing it every now and again is not enough to keep you up in the rankings to be in those big TV tournaments, and that's where he's going to have to be if he's going to be back in the top 32.
Yeah, if you're going to be in the top echelons of the rankings,
58,
you've got to be making strides in UK Opens, Players' Championship Finals. You've got to be making a match play or a Grand Prix or both. And you've got to be winning matches at these big ranking tournaments. It's as simple as that. And the European 56. Tour, it's got to play its part too. You've got to be getting to those events more often than not.
The chance has gone now for Kuivenhoven, so Whitlock will come back. And yeah, the European Tour is something that's bolstered his career. You know, he's so consistent in the early years of the European Tour. But he'll be fighting to just get on those Euro Tour stages for the next year. Can he use that? No, he can't.
32.
It's a very conventional barrel 99. That Simon is using these days compared to some that he's used in the past. And Robert Owen took this out a little bit earlier, but he didn't go for double 18, he went for tops.
63.
And Whitlock has a chance to break the throw.
16. Edge on the first leg.
Double four Simon does the job. Simon Whitlock.
Simon to throw first.
Does take the opening leg. Can tell you that John Henderson did win his game, which means he will be back on this board
next against Jan van Veen. Now, if you don't like that game, you don't like darts.
No clash of generations. Mind you, this kind of is, to be fair. Kuivenhoven's not a spring chicken, but he's certainly nearer the start of his career than Simon Whitlock.
Every now and again, I catch myself thinking that certain players are still in the elite because they're part of the generation that made this sport boom even more. I think about Adrian Lewis, who's obviously not here this weekend through choice. Whitlock, who was here through choice. But they have something in common, those two. And no, it's nothing to do with the World Cup. They both have not won a European Tour event in 12 years.
Well, look, Simon Whitlock's World Cup victory in 2022 alongside Damon Hatter was his first title of any sort for half a decade. It's 2017 since he last won a ranking title. That is an awful long time. Now, in between, he's had some amazing runs in TV tournaments. Now, obviously, the World Cup win, but a brilliant display at the Grand Slam of Darts. There was a period where he basically owned Michael van Gerwen. But Simon Whitlock was a prolific title winner, and he hasn't been that for a number of years now. He's still been good enough to play more than his par in some of the biggest tournaments in the world. But, I mean, it's a long while since you've seen him do anything of note at the World Championship, isn't it? And ultimately, that's where the biggest prize money, the biggest jumps in the rankings can be won and made.
And I can't see Whitlock going to Q School. If he was to lose his card either this year or the next, I just cannot see him doing it.
I don't know, he could surprise you. Kuivenhoven looking to surprise Whitlock here, but he's not going to take the 149.
97. Simon Rigg, 115.
Well, options here. A lot of people like the bull on this these days. Simon's a bit more of a conventional cat, and that's one of the shots that doesn't help him.
83.
I wouldn't be surprised if these barrels were his old pal Gigi's, you know. They look very similar. Gordon Mathers.
Yeah,
winner on the DP Tour recently, Gigi. But I remember when Gigi was here living with Simon in the Portsmouth area, there was a Players' Championship that you and I covered, and he was using these darts, and we found out they were Gordon's darts.
Well, he does chop and change. He knocks up bits of kit in his garage at home.
Surrounded by guinea pigs.
Yeah, guinea pigs, frogs, dogs, all sorts. He's the Dr. Doolittle of Hampshire.
Did you ever hear about what he called his cat? He adopted Northy. A ginger cat, called it Northy.
Yeah. Because it was ginger, but nowhere near as annoying as Richard North.
Didn't talk as much.
Well,
you must have seen on social media in the last 24 hours, Richard North had a new style of dart case yesterday. He took a Tupperware container onto a stage, and the lid was off, and it was just full of miscellaneous dart flights and stems.
Whatever works for you, North.
Well, I think it was very similar to that of the bag of Simon Whitlock, which I'm sure the bottom of it has never seen the light of day.
Another wizard with a second max. Looking good on his own throw here. I can tell you Boris Kritchmar's another player to have booked his place in the fourth round tonight. 6-1 win against Richie Edhouse, 96 average.
Well, shots off now, but no panic. He will return. That is not something he's going to be happy with. The only bright side there, very similar to that of Jermaine Watamina in the previous match. At least he's taken the 27 off.
140.
Kuivenhoven, and all of a sudden, he's back in with a chance of holding his throw. Yes, holding his throw. We've had two breaks, haven't we?
80. Mike Rikwai, 113.
Double 18. Going to be found.
57. Simon, you require 20.
Double 10 is one of his favourites, usually. He likes it straight down the pipe to the 15s, the 6s, and the 10s, right down his eye line. And comes up trumps there for a break of throw on a 2-1 lead. This is another one of those third round matches. It's all about just getting in the hat for later. You don't care which number you've got, as long as you've got one. And then you will go back to wherever you're staying, or possibly stick around if you're playing later in the afternoon. And then tailor your preparation based on the time slot you get. Players like Whitlock, who have been here many, many times, tend to work on a three-hour system 46. Before game one, and then later on, probably about a two-hour window to make sure they're ready for the next match.
Things like the European Tour, and obviously Taunton, you know, he's no stranger to the UK Open, he's won the European Championship. Tournaments where you're playing multiple big stage games a day. And these still, I know, even if you're on the outer boards, it will feel different from a Players' Championship event. There is still a crowd there. There is still stuff to do that isn't just get up from your table and walk 10 yards to your board.
Yeah, very much so, especially if you're playing on board 8, where you've got to walk all the way through what is going to be a very, very busy room. And it was extremely busy last year when Luke Littler was playing against Richie Edhouse. He was grabbing a lot of the attention. And I'm sure that young man will get a lot of attention in the draw later.
Yes, I'm sure he will. Luke Littler, of course, this is the first senior PDC tournament that he played last year.
30, sir.
Lost to Adam Gavlas, the eventual semi-finalist. Averaged 100 in that game, Littler as well.
Do you think there's any chance that Luke Littler could be on this board later?
I very much doubt it.
I couldn't even finish that sentence.
I think you're more likely to see the defending champion Andrew Gilding on this board.
41. Simon, you require 115.
Danny Notler, when he was defending, he got put on, was it board 3?
I think he might have done that thing.
96 left. He hits that.
75. Mike, you require 96.
That's 96 for 3 this time for Mike.
It looked a decent guide. He finds it for double 8.
80.
Missed opportunity. Could we have the first hold of throw in this game after 3 consecutive breaks?
Top wire. Just falls a little bit short. But tens is good again. For a 3-1 advantage for the Aussie.
Game on.
Australian darts is begging for another injection at the minute. You've got Hetter who's doing really well. Whitlock sticking around. There's definitely room for another one. I just wonder who it's going to be. Could it be Brandon Weening? Maybe he's a good player. Could we see it from Harley Kemp? He's decent. He's been sticking around the DPS circuit for a while. Could GG make a return to the UK? You just never know.
Yeah, you're never quite sure who's going to go on. When we first saw Damon Hetter, there weren't the signs that he was going to become the player that he is.
I'm sure a visit down to Wollongong in August will give us a bit more information about that.
World Series events back. Wollongong and in New Zealand. Back-to-back events over August. Both won by Rob Cross last year, of
43.
Course.
He was pretty useful last night, even though he to Nathan Aspinall.
910 average in his opening game just down the road in Exeter. Cross will be coming here in good form.
And someone who has never won the UK Open.
He'd make the final when he lost out to Aspinall in 2019. And of course, this is the tournament where he first saw Rob Cross.
81.
But Whitlock looking for a 4-1 lead here. Double 12. Double 6.
69. He's
glad that he didn't bust his score in the end, because that was perilously close to double 13.
Horrible thing to happen when you go for double 6 and you bust his score. However, Kuivenhoven does not get a look at the ball to finish the leg.
95.
But he finds it to lead tops.
12.
Double 6 for Whitlock. I said he was good in this corner of the board. Tens have been good. Now he needs the trapdoor down at 3s. Hits that with a passion.
No score.
Mike Kuivenhoven has been unable to hold his throw so far in this game. Yeah, that changes now, but it's only changed because Whitlock has missed a succession of darts at double, 4 in total for a 4-1 lead.
I'm eagle-eyeing these stems here, Dan, because they're not even matching.
140.
He has got form with that, though, hasn't he?
He has got form, but going even... I'm not shooting Mickeys anymore. There's some left, right? There's some colour. There's same left. There's same colour. So you've got to move up across the corner. I am positive that they don't even make them anymore, and they haven't for years. These are antiques.
Well, these will be fished out for me. Dark bag or his garage or who knows what.
He probably woke up this morning and thought, I don't even know what stems I'm going to use. And he's found three stems at the bottom of his bag. I'll just use those.
180.
Oh, a bit like Peter Wright, when you do chop and change your equipment like Whitlock does, it does mean that you're never going 92. To be going into a game wedded to a particular thing. Like, if you do not have it, I won't be able to play without these. It's not like Gurney, who's used the same setup for so long.
Kuivenhoven's the same. He hasn't changed a thing since he graced the tour. Same colour scheme. He's always got that coloured shirt on. He's always got the matching flights. Barrels haven't changed a bit.
54.
He has a formula that he's comfortable with. And he doesn't want to change it.
Looking to make the wizard feel a little uncomfortable. Here, bullseye would level the game.
96.
Similar shot. Simon Whitlock, but he gets to stay on the 18 segment. Ooh, can he find another? That leaves the ball, and the wizard pins it. Crucial shot from the Australian. A moment ago, he could have been 4-1 up. Missed loads of darts to do so. And then the very next leg, Kuivenhoven misses the ball to make it 3-all, and then Whitlock pins it for 4-2.
That bullseye as well just makes a slightly different sound to any part of the board. Listen to the sound of the treble 20. It's got a lovely thud to it, but when you hit the ball, because of the way the dartboards are made, it just has a little bit of extra pop to it. Especially in a moment like that, to give yourself that two-leg cushion once again. Great shot.
Although Whitlock did beat Kuivenhoven when they played at the UK Open, that was their first meeting. Kuivenhoven's won the subsequent two.
140.
So it's not like Mike hasn't had the feeling of beating Whitlock.
He's in the same sort of bracket as Nenches, isn't he? Not so much a Q school yo-yo, but someone who is always teetering around the 64.
Yeah, and he's 58. He's had runs in pro tour events, but a bit like we were saying about Whitlock, the odd run here and there is not enough to really break through, get you into that bracket of players who's challenging for the biggest tournament spots in Blackpool, spots at the World Grand Prix.
45.
Oh, Whitlock surely wants to hit a ton here to leave 1-2-2 again. He's not going to do that.
48.
Fact, he hasn't even left to finish.
Yeah, a real mess, just handing the initiative to Mike Kuivenhoven. Double 16's cut the gap to just one leg again. That's what he's managed.
Just a very, very tidy dart player. This one doesn't float your boat. I'm sure the next match will. John Henderson against Jan van Veen.
Oh,
word, that's a good game.
Certainly could be. Van Veen's been winning a lot of games at the start of this year on the Pro Tour. Early days, granted. And he's not been doing as eye-catching stuff as the likes of Ryan Searle or Gary Anderson. But he has been winning matches, and quite a lot of them.
Easy one.
Do you think Simon will ever cut his hair? Or will he just be like that forever?
I think it might be classed as a listed building or something nowadays. I'm not sure he's allowed to.
Yeah, may actually go down in history as one of the premier sporting haircuts of all time. But you know, there used to be a bounty on his ponytail in the early days.
Really?
Somebody placed a £10,000 bounty on his ponytail. He was very watchful of people with shears.
180.
He needs to keep an eye on Maik Kuivenhoven. It's four legs running, but the Dutchman has hit a maximum. Now, that's a great shot from the Wizard to leave himself on tops. But if he doesn't take it out in the next visit, Kuivenhoven may well be on the same.
I think this is a very encouraging display from Whitlock. There's a lot of really good assured shots coming in here. This will be another one. Double 10 again. Not this time. And he knows that that could be painful. Magnified by this shot from Mike.
Maik Kuivenhoven has leveled up this match. A few moments ago, he had to survive four darts from Whitlock to take a 4-1 lead. It is now 4-4. Kuivenhoven has the darts in two of the three remaining legs.
Doesn't seem to break a sweat at any point, Kuivenhoven. Very much like Pascal Ruprecht from earlier. He lost out. The person who's sweating a little bit more right now is the seasoned Whitlock, but how many times has he dug his way out of a jam like this in dramatic fashion? He's had some great finishes to games in his career. Remember that 146 he hit against Jamie Cavan at the 2013 European Championship? And he also had a 110 against Joe Cullen in the semis of the Europeans in 2018.
Yeah, the European Championship has been the scene of some of Simon Whitlock's greatest exploits. Obviously winning it, but then going to the final as he looked to defend it. And as you mentioned, much later on, still being a threat at that tournament. And that is a brilliant visit from the Wizard.
The ability to get onto that finish when Kuivenhoven was just outside one is brilliant, but now he has to finish it. Mike's done his job. This is an enormous moment. Double 5.
425.
Five perfect darts to give himself opportunity, but double 5 is missed by the Wizard, and he might be going behind in this match for the first time. Double top for 5-4. Double 10. Kuivenhoven sneaks it in the corner for the lead.
Such a good play. I always say that when you go for double 10, go for the top third. You don't want to be anywhere near that double 15, or indeed the single. But Whitlock's not done yet.
Well, they're averaging pretty much the same. It's just over 90. But the real difference is Maik Kuivenhoven is 50% on his doubles, and Simon Whitlock is less than 24% on his doubles. He is 4 out of 17, 13 misses at double. And 4 of those were for that fifth leg where he could have gone 4-1 up. And that might have been game over.
95.
When you don't have the darts at the start of a match, you've got to say to yourself sometimes, will I back myself if it goes to leg 11? I think it's very dependent on whether you win leg 10. You might not win leg 10.
Whitlock purposefully left the 170. He's not going to take it out. He does get one treble, but Kuivenhoven, the maximum, has given him a little sniff.
Well, that was a Lukman style safe 20 there.
57. Simon, you're
no big treble and no big reaction to that as Whitlock tries to take 76 before Kuivenhoven gets a chance at it. Double 18. Same height. Brilliantly done. If you think that's an accident, think again. He likes shots that are the same height, so he doesn't have to go high to low to high. And now we go the distance, and Whitlock has got the opportunity to break in the last leg. Let's see how he fares.
nine maximums in this game. It's 5-4 to Kuivenhoven in that particular tally. But if we get to double figures, that may be the decisive shot in this last leg decider. Has Whitlock got another 180 in him? He might need it. Kuivenhoven's been able to hold the past two times he's thrown first in 15 darts.
45.
But he's barely past 400 after two visits. Advantage Whitlock.
Very much so now. He's got a two treble lead. And he's got experience that Kuivenhoven does not have. And here's a little tidbit for you. If Whitlock was to win this tournament, he'd become the oldest winner. The oldest winner being Taylor at 53. Simon's now 54.
100.
He is down to a finish, Simon Whitlock. Can he get another? No, he can't. He's down to a better finish, but it's not that much better, to be honest, Mike Kuivenhoven. It's still Whitlock's. He could win it right now. He needed the treble 20 for a go at the bullseye, but he pins the bullseye last dart to leave tops for the match. If this goes, this will be excruciating. No good first dart, meaning Whitlock gets one visit to finish this off. Three clean darts at tops to be in the wizard hat. Mike Kuivenhoven did so well to battle back into this game, but he's faltered right at the end. And the wizard wants double 10 and cannot find it. But Kuivenhoven's nightmare visit in the previous turn means he's still got a huge mountain to climb.
If we'd said 130 for the match, very doable. 131 is just one more point, but it's so much harder. 51 tops. There you go. After one miss on a 130 in a single, you can still take it, but with 131, you can't.
Whitlock has missed doubles in this match. 16 of them in total. But he doesn't miss again, and the wizard wins it in a last leg decider. Simon Whitlock, the two-time quarter-finalist, is through to round four. He's in the hat with the rest of the big boys, and make no mistake, the wizard still considers himself to be one of the biggest.